We made a very clear offer to them. We've said clearly a Leave alliance can deliver a thumping majority. And actually, the country now wants some certainty. And there's lots of Brexit fatigue out there. I think there's a new thing. There's almost like sort of parliament, zombie parliament fatigue out there. We, you know, we need some certainty. And then actually we get some clarity. Businesses know how to plan.
And what response have you had on Brexit alliance? It's been rejected, hasn't it?
No, look, actually, there are all sorts of people out there who are really keen on some form of alliance. The reality is that both Tory party members and voters want some certainty. They want a big majority to get Brexit over the line. And what we're saying is we want a proper Brexit. We've got serious concerns about this deal. You know, there are flaws and pitfalls.
All right. So let's be clear about this. Suppose there is an election in the second week of December, which is on the cards now. What is the Brexit Party going to do? Are you going to stand candidates in every seat in Great Britain?
Look, we're going to look at the options. I'm not going to give a running commentary on live TV. There's a variety of ways that an alliance can be constructed so that we can get a decent proper Brexit. Look, we've made an offer to the Conservatives. It's in their court.
You know, would stand down in favour of Conservatives.
We've said we would always put country before party. We would expect the Conservatives to do the same because this now is an issue of confidence in our democratic system. Confidence in getting Brexit done, and that's what people
want. Do you have any chance of getting any MPs, do you think?
Oh, without question. Just a question.
Hello. Yes, that's right. You've just watched Richard Tice, chairman of the Brexit Party, being interviewed on Sky News by Adam Bolton. Mr. Tice talks about a Leave alliance. A Leave alliance with who, Mr. Tice? The Tories. Well, I've got some bad news for you here. The Tories, Boris Johnson, they view you, Nigel Farage and the Brexit Party as the enemy. Like you should view the Tories as the enemy because they are. And when I put this to you, you'll understand a bit more clear as to why a Leave alliance is just not going to happen. Those running the Tory party, those running Britain, they are not patriots like that brave man was, right? Or even Enoch Powell or Éire Nive or maybe even Winston Churchill. The new patriot is a liberal now in the Tory party and those running the Tory party and Britain. The new patriot is a liberal. So it's not the patriotism I'm familiar with or probably yourself, Nigel Farage. Right? It's a different type of patriotism. It's a weak jellyfish liberal patriotism. And once you understand that, you can see why an alliance with the Tories is just ludicrous and not going to happen. You see, it doesn't matter who gets in power, who wins the general election in December. It doesn't matter. They will still sell Brexit out, the Tories or Labour. So instead of wasting time believing you can extend the hand of cooperation, friendship to the Tories and form this Leave alliance to keep Jeremy Corbyn out and deliver Brexit, you need to concentrate on your own MPs now and getting them elected. You see, the new Liberal patriot in the Tory party, they would rather run the gamble of Jeremy Corbyn winning the general election than form an alliance with you, Nigel Farage and the Brexit Party. And once you understand that, you will see them, what you're dealing with. The Liberals now, they're not patriots like that brave man, Enoch Powell, Éire Nive. You've got, get your candidates ready, Mr. Tice. Get as many elected as possible. Unseat those Tory sellouts and traitors. Then at the very least, whoever wins the general election, Tories or Labour, sell Brexit out. You will at least then have a foot in the door and a voice in Parliament where the real fight begins. Because this isn't just for Brexit. It's for the soul of Britain and its very future and existence. OK, thank you.